heard about is learning vector quantization and something else. But let me start just where is Mittweida? Mittweida in Germany is in the middle of nowhere. So it is in the southeastern part, just nearby Dresden, and 300 kilometers in the south of Berlin. And our university is a small one, which was founded 150 years ago, and it has 5 faculties and approximately 6,000 students. And since last year, we have the Saxony Institute for Computational Intelligence and Machine Learning, and we have 2 chapters inside, which is the application of computational intelligence and machine learning for big data analysis, data mining and decision making, and the mathematical investigation and algorithm development for machine learning, the CI group. So now you know at least a little bit about Mittweida, and there was a nice citation of a PhD student from France, and she said to me, Mittweida is a little bit small as compared to Paris. Okay, that's it. Now let's start with a topic, and the topic is that learning vector quantization, or generalized learning vector quantization, is one scheme and many variants for many different aspects of classification learning. And this is basically the learning vector quantization as a sparse classifier, as introduced by Thiervo Kohorn. Then I will go to the generalized variant, which is just that we have a cost function for the stochastic gradient descent learning, but keeps the interpretability as introduced by Kohorn. And then I will switch over to show you how we can develop different variants of this generalized learning vector quantization scheme just depending on tasks to be solved. And as the last point, I will show you that this generalized learning vector quantization scheme can be taken as a multi-layer network approach, and so we can relate easily to deep learning algorithms and deep learning approaches too. So this is the outline of my talk, and I will start with learning vector quantization as motivated by Thiervo Kohorn. And let's start with a simple distance-based classifier. So the paradigm is the nearest neighbor approach. And if I have a nearest neighbor classifier, then we have to store a set of labeled examples, and we classify a new data point according to the label of the nearest neighbors. And if we do so, we have local decision boundaries, and of course, usually we use Euclidean distance for that, and at the end we end up with a piecewise linear class borders.